Well, looky, looky what we have here, GB. I mean, here's the thing. I know, like, as the commentary team, we have to have words, we have to speak. But whenever I see this Jersey Mike character, I have no words.
Jersey Mike has more junk in the trunk than a 68 Oldsmobile. I'm at this point lost for words with him, but here's the deal. The business, the Rock and Shock Connection, whatever they're calling themselves, they have managed to align themselves here, of course, with Jersey Mike. And the question is whether or not it will prove to be sufficient or acceptable. Wow.
And look at this onesie he's got on.
I'll just say this. I did not know that Jersey Mike had a BBL. That's all. I didn't know. I didn't know. I guess there's hope for some folks, huh?
I'm going to tell you what, though. The business are the real deal. I mean, they could go. We saw them in action last month. But now they've got their handful here with the Nasty Team. Some more great tag team action coming your way right here at Championship District Wrestling. Stunt Marshall, one of the members here of the Nasty Team, as they make their way out. Of course, the Nasty Team, one of the fastest rising groups worldwide. They say Nasty Team worldwide for a reason, GB.
Well, that's what they say. They've got chapters apparently all over the world. And here we go.
Here's Shaheem Ali. And of course, accompanied by the leader of the Nasty Team, Nasty Leroy himself. As they take command of the ring, as the business exits the ring.
Well, it's pretty impressive to see the folks that Nasty Leroy has managed to assemble worldwide. I'm not sure, do you know the philosophy that he has to be able to bring together such pretty incredible talent?
I have no idea. There you hear it from the leader of the Nasty Team himself there. Not making friends with the business. I can't get over it. Is Jersey Mike really going to stand on this side of the ring? I'm not sure if I can look at this the whole match.
Well, I don't know.
It's like a car crash. You slow down. You don't want to look at it, but you can't help but slow down and look.
Well, I'm going to find something else to look at for sure. But however you look at it, this should be a very intriguing tag team match here. Of course, we have seen here in CDW before what the business can do. This will be the first opportunity for the CDW faithful to check out what the Nasty Team can do. The team of Stunt Marshall and Shaheem Ali. Stunt Marshall kicking things off right now against Caleb Tennedy.
We got a little conversation going on.
Yeah.
Greco-Roman knuckle lock? Is that what we're going to start out with, a test of strength?
Yeah, you know, this is intriguing to me because Tennedy calls himself the shock factor of professional wrestling. And really, looking around this ring, he might have some competition here.
There's a lot of shocking things we've seen, not only in this match, but all throughout the night here.
You better believe it. But look at the power there of Stunt Marshall. Who has really been in this business for quite some time. This is year number 12 for Stunt Marshall. A former GCW champion trained by Marty Jannetty, one half of the Rockers. And he believes that with hate, all things are possible.
Stunt Marshall, quite the build on him here.
Yeah.
Showing the strength advantage as Tennedy trying to take him down with those shoulder blocks. It's not going to work.
Did he just say he can't see me?
I'm pretty sure, but we can all see him, so I don't know what he's talking about.
We certainly can.
There's a deep arm drag there from Stunt Marshall now. Now with the advantage over Caleb Tennedy.
So as you were mentioning power and the like, certainly the power advantage in this particular match would have to go to the Nasty Team of Stunt Marshall and Shaheem Ali.
So far it looks that way, and this is a huge shoulder block there, to your point, GB, from Stunt Marshall.
But the thing is, for the business, they aren't intimidated by that. They are used to going into scenarios where they are the underdogs in terms of size. But they always manage to work around the size disadvantage with speed and cunning.
You're right, we saw them in action last month as they faced Ernest the Cat Miller, wrestling legend, as well as the much stronger Victor Rall, our bartender here, and of course, able to hold their own, at least for the most part. They, of course, did not win that matchup.
Well, they held their own, and I think that's the important thing here. And now here comes Casey Rocker.
Look at the size here of Shaheem Ali.
He's the chief rocker, in case anybody asks.
Casey Rockerson in the ropes. Oh, looking for a hip toss here. Looking for one of his own. Oh, it's a, getting an arm drag there by Ali.
The kind of agility that Ali had behind that mixed with his strength really added some special stake on it.
Oh,
oh my gosh.
My goodness.
Now that will adjust your attitude very quickly.
It'll adjust your attitude, it'll adjust your spine.
You better believe it. You don't need a chiropractor after that.
Look at the size of Ali. And of course, Rocker tried to get him into the ropes, couldn't do it, but he hit that spinning heel kick right in the midsection. Now Ali gets reversed into the ropes. And look at Jersey Mike. Look at this despicable guy on the outside.
Jersey Mike.
Grabbing the foot there of Ali. And it was just enough of a distraction for Casey Rocker to take advantage.
And listen, it's that kind of chicanery that makes the business so dangerous. And there's a tag into Caleb Tennedy.
And now the Rock and Shock connection, whatever you want to call them, the business taking advantage. And look at Jersey Mike.
Jersey Mike distracted. The ref couldn't see what was going on there.
Stunt Marshall not doing his teammate any favors there, distracting the referee inadvertently.
I got to tell you, I don't know. Oh, wait a minute. We've got a shoving match going on now. Of sorts between Nasty Leroy and Jersey Mike.
Back in the ring. The business.
Woo! What a step up in Seguri there.
What a shot there for Casey Rocker. Ali might be out. Can he take advantage here? There's a pin attempt.
And the kind
just
of
one count.
And the kind of tag team continuity that we just saw there with the business is what makes them dangerous. Again, they're able to use their chemistry and their know-how, their natural partnership, to be able to overcome folks of larger size and speed.
And you see Casey Rocker trying to slow down the big man, trying to cut off that air supply, but he's just not strong enough. It's Ali trying to get back up to a vertical pace.
Well, you know, the thing that has to happen here, I think that the business has to make quick tags. I think they have to continue to keep the pace of this fast and methodical. Ooh. And not let this get into a place of speed, or a place of power, rather, because if this becomes a power match, it's all about Ali and Stunt Marshall.
Well, there you go, to your point. Here comes the power, up and over. And Tennedy landed hard, now a shot right to the midsection there from the big man, Ali. Oh, look at that back kick right to the forehead.
And did you see the facial expressions of Ali change? Now you can tell there's about to be a problem here for the business.
Tennedy in a bad way here. Ooh. Double stomp right to the spine there, Tennedy, from Stunt Marshall.
And Stunt Marshall now backs him into the corner.
Marshall, he's walking a tightrope there on the center strand, and a shot right across the back of the neck there to Tennedy. Tennedy swings and he misses. Oh, atomic drop there from Stunt Marshall.
But he held it.
He's not done yet. Oh, and he just planted him. Backside first, center of the ring. And Tennedy landed hard.
Now, if that were...
Wow. Look out. Stunt Marshall was going after Jersey Mike. Instead, Casey Rocker stepped up with that enziguri.
And that's the thing about this tandem, of course, of the business and Jersey Mike. When they get together, they have figured out how to distract people long enough to take them off course and once again get the advantage in this matchup.
Tennedy and Rocker now just working over Stunt Marshall in the corner.
And people, you know, you look at the nefarious ways, of course, of the business, and you miss.
Whoa!
What a DDT! That was nasty!
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my!
We almost had a three count there.
Yeah, a three count and a need for a stretcher.
Stunt Marshall able to kick out just barely. I'm not even sure how. Purely out of instinct, imagine.
Purely, I think he's going to be feeling that one the rest of this week.
Now just being choked right across that top rope there by Casey Rocker. Across the middle rope, rather.
I'll tell you what, I'm not sure what the training regimen is for the Nasty team, but they've got to figure out how they can get past the nefarious ways and the chicanery, dare I say, of the business.
Stunt Marshall in a world of trouble now. Casey Rocker dragging back into enemy territory. Blind tag there to Caleb Kennedy. Now just stomping the midsection there. Well, Stunt Marshall is the business. Oh, and there's an elbow drop there for Kennedy. Kennedy floats over for the pin attempt here.
Count of one. And think about this. A win for either team is going to be extremely important here for their continued standings here in CDW.
You're right. At this point, we do not have tag team titles, but you got to imagine all these tag teams, and we've had plenty of tag team matches thus far in our two shows.
That's right.
They're wanting to be the best tag team in the company.
Absolutely, because certainly you'd be considered, you know, whenever the time comes for those championships.
Big move there for Casey Rocker. Kick right to the spine there. Stump Marshall, another pin attempt. Not going to be enough there. He did not get a leg hooked, and that might have cost him.
So this is going to be the dangerous thing for the business. The business knows that they cannot outpower the Nasty team, so they're going to have to wear them down, and that's going to continue to take moves like this.
Oh! But look at this. Stump Marshall able to land on his feet back in the corner. Back elbow there to Kennedy, and a big boot to Casey Rocker. Up on the second turnbuckle. Oh, double drop kick takes down both members of the business.
And here was the very smart strategy there of the business. By continuing to make those quick tags, they were literally wearing out the energy, of course, of Stunt Marshall. But now Marshall makes it to the corner to the power man, Shaheem Ali.
And here comes Ali, taking out both members of the business. And look at the agility of the big man.
Those Booker T-like scissor kicks are very, very special and extremely powerful from Shaheem Ali.
Oh, big splash in the corner on Rocker. Sweeps out the legs, and there's one for Kennedy as well.
Big time splash there. Sweeps the leg.
Uh-oh. What's he got in line here? Look out, ref. Oh, basement dropkick right across the teeth of Casey Rocker.
And he's not done.
He is not done yet. Look out, Kennedy. Oh! Kennedy tried to check to see if his nose is still attached to his face.
I guess so, because there was no room between his feet and the turnbuckle.
And this crowd coming alive for Shaheem Ali. Look at the strength here.
Muscling him up.
Good gracious. Just muscling up Kennedy. Oh, look out.
Oh,
powerbomb, pin attempt. Will it be enough? That's got to do it. Rocker able to make the save at the last possible second. He takes out Stunt Marshall on the ring apron as well.
This is impressive. Highly impressive.
Smart move by Casey Rocker, dragging his partner back over to the corner. So now Rocker is the legal man. And what's he got in mind here as he tries to get Ali back to a vertical base? Oh, look at the strength. He just slam dunked him, GP.
He slam dunked him with absolutely no problem and didn't even alley-oop.
Made it look easy.
And now, will Ali fly?
Are you kidding me? The big man going up top.
But look at this.
Look at Jersey Mike. Jersey Mike grabbing the leg of Ali and Kennedy. Just enough time for Kennedy to take advantage here.
And I'll tell you what, the third man is huge for this team of the business.
Uh-oh. Now both members of the business going up top. All three of these guys in a precarious position here. What do they have in mind? But look at Stump Marshall.
Stump
Marshall makes a tag, a blind tag there, and I don't think the business realized it.
Look at this. Here comes the Tower of Doom.
Oh! Everybody's down.
Everybody.
What a crazy series of events there. Stump Marshall comes in. You see the Tower of Doom. Both members of the business are down. Both members of the Nasty team are down. But Kennedy and Stump Marshall back up to their feet now.
Woo!
And Marshall with the advantage, taking it to both members of the business. But now the numbers game comes into play here, and it's just too much.
It certainly does. Reversal there.
Oh, spoke too soon. A meeting of the minds here for the business. Marshall, he ducks a clothesline. What's he got in mind here? Oh!
Woo!
Beautiful suplex there, but he's hanging on. He's not done yet.
Oh, wow.
Turns him inside out, GB.
That's unusual, but a big move there from Stump Marshall. But Marshall is clearly worn out.
And a chop to the back there, or is he, GB? That just might have made him angry.
Uh-oh. And you're not going to like Stump when he's angry.
Firing away with those right hands of Casey Rocker.
He's stunting up. There's the big boot.
And there's the big boot.
You know what comes next.
And there's a chop to the back for good measure.
Uh-oh.
Now, wait a second. We thought we knew it was coming next, but now Jersey Mike's up, distracting the ref, and here comes Nasty Leroy on the outside.
Nasty Leroy.
Leroy going after Jersey Mike.
Oh. Stump Marshall.
Stump Marshall got hung up on the ropes, and now a pin attempt here. I think
he's got a tag.
No. He had a handful of tights here in the business, doing dirty business here tonight. Unbelievable.
A big win for the business. We knew this win would be significant relative to where people would stand, of course, in CDW, but a massive, massive win here for the business.
By hook or by crook, they get it done, whether you like them or not. The business with a victory here.
A big, big win here, and you gotta wonder, will the Nasty team somehow manage to reconfigure who they are? But we got a concerning situation, I think, in the ring here, KC Rocker.
KC Rocker still down. Of course, the business did get the win here. Wait a second. Caleb Kennedy still getting in the face here of Stump Marshall. This might not be the last we're going to see here of the Nasty team and the business.
Clearly not.
There's a big boot there to Kennedy.
Meanwhile, Nasty, look at this.
Oh, Shaheem Ali.
Chaos.
Shaheem Ali.
Oh, my God.
Just planted Rocker and Nasty Leroy taking it to Jersey Mike. There's a leg drop there to Kennedy from Stunt Marshall.
That stunt leg drop. And it is just pandemonium right now. And now they have left Jersey Mike in the ring.
Jersey Mike in trouble here.
Jersey Mike's in big trouble. And I don't know what are they gonna do.
Uh-oh, look out. Oh, there's a big cutter there from Nasty Leroy. And I believe he got all of the junk in all of the trunk. Well, they didn't win the match, but the Nasty team is standing tall right here.
They certainly are. Another chaotic end to this matchup here. A crazy night here in CDW.
It has been a wild one so far, GB, and I tell you what, we're far from done, my man.
Listen, it's been said this simple. We ain't done, and we aren't done. What a crazy, chaotic night here in CDW. This is nuts.
We've got a long way to go. We've got several more matches here. That was wild. I can't believe Jersey Mike gets taken out with a cutter. Luckily, Stump Marshall doing everybody a favor here, getting Leroy out of the ring.
Well, there you go.
I tell you, man, you never know what's going to happen here. We say it all the time.
It's highly unpredictable in these Atlanta streets, and such is the case here at CDW. You just never know what's going to happen. What a chaotic and crazy moment and crazy match here.
Wow.
At CDW. What in the world?